Waterstones in Europe. It's got so many floors and I could just get lost in there. It's really, really cool. So we visited there, and then we also went to the British Library, which has a lot of study area for students and things, and really old collections of manuscripts, you know, pages from history, kind of in nice glass cases that you can look around. But they also have a bookshop, which has a really nice collection in there. I was actually really surprised. It feels very cherry-picked. And then we also went to possibly the best bookshop I have ever been to, and it's called Word on the Water. Word on the Water. And it's basically a barge on the water, kind of just behind St. Pancras. And on this barge, there are loads of books, a roaring fire, an armchair, and a lovely comfy sofa. Boat's kind of rocking a little bit, and on top they also sell books. They've got loads of plants, like the kind of vibe where you have ivy growing out of old boots and things like that. And there was two guys on top, they were playing saxophone and drums. So now let's get on to the books.
She pretty much runs the show because she is the last
mentioned to me that the topics of death are handled really well by DJ Clune, and I believe this person because I feel like I'm in safe hands with him. So, DJ Clune, that is. It sounds like it has quite a lot of uplifting qualities to it, as well as being centered around death. And I love the idea of a tea shop that helps people pass over to the other side. Like, that's such a creative idea. So I love that in a book when they try something really weird. Also sounds quite wholesome and cozy, the idea of a tea shop. So let's hope that those feelings run throughout this book. I'm really excited to try this because I love the writing style of DJ Clune. I think he's so funny. If you've read House in the Cerulean Sea, some of the one-liners that Linus Baker thinks in his head, I just, oh, gold. I actually laughed out loud at a lot of them. So let's hope this is as good as I'm hoping it to be. The last book I got from Waterstones is this one right here, What Moves the Dead. So this is meant to be a retelling of Edgar Allan Poe's The House of Usher. And we have Alex, who is a retired soldier, who receives word that his friend, I think she's called Madeline Usher, is dying. So he rushes to the home, The House of Usher, to see her. When he arrives, he finds that everything So now we just have the two books that I got from Word on the Water. And the first one is a second-hand book, The Unlikely Pilgrimage of Harold Fry by Rachel Joyce. I've just finished reading a book by Rachel Joyce called Miss Benson's Beetle, and it was so full of heart and unexpected tension that I just want to read more. And this book is a little bit similar in that it follows a journey, so I'm hoping that I'm going to like this as much as I liked Miss Benson's Beetle. The characters were absolutely wonderful, and as I say, I wasn't expecting it to be such a roller coaster of a book. This follows Harold Fry, who is an elderly man who lives in a small British house with his wife. And one day he receives a letter from a lady called Queenie. Queenie is someone from his past, and the letter says that she is in hospice and she's writing to say goodbye. So instead of just jotting down a quick note back, Harold decides that he needs to walk all the way to her hospice in Berwick-on-Tweed, which is 600 miles from where he is. And he's undergone some kind of illusion that the more he, if he keeps on walking, she'll be okay. Quite heart-wrenching, really. books from my London trip based on authors I've already read and loved, and hoping that the second book I read of theirs is going to be as good. So let's hope that's good logic. Secret Garden by Frances Hodgson.